Good afternoon to one and all. My name is Sharanya. I'm studying BSc in PCS second year from Vivekananda Government Degree College. And my topic is the film Mahanati. Mahanati is based on the life history of Savitri Garu, who is a legendary actress with great humanity. This movie is directed by Nag Ashwin, and the best music from Mahanati is composed by Mickey J. Mayer. And in the opening of this film, in the opening of this film, a newspaper editor suggests one of his employee Madhuravani, which is composed by Samantha Akkineni. She's the writer in this movie, and she researches about Savitri to write the story and to publish it in the newspaper. So from this, during her research, all along with Madhuravani, we audience also will learn many facts about Savitri. Some of them are, the first thing we will come to know is we should not call Savitri as Savitri because she deserves a lot of respect. So we should call her Savitri Garu. And the next thing, after childhood of Savitri Garu, her uncle takes her to Madras film industry to earn some money by making her heroine. So she is given a dialogue to deliver where she fails to deliver because of nervousness and tension. So, and she is removed from that role. Then in aggressiveness, she practices a lot and finally she gets a role in the movie. And she keeps the role very beautifully and she gets many other roles in many movies. And she becomes a top heroine of those times. And this is the first part. And after, including in first part, we'll also see that she falls in love with her co-actor, Jemini Ganesan, who is also married and he had children also. Even though she loves him and marries him because she can't be without him. And their married life goes very beautifully and Savitri Garu delivers a baby girl and a baby boy. And after a few years, Savitri Garu is with her legendary acting. She becomes the topmost heroine. With her success, her husband Jemini Ganesan gets jealous of her and he started taking alcohol due to pain because she's busy with her acting. So he's in pain. And when Savitri Garu comes to know about this incident, she tries to stop Jemini Ganesan from taking alcohol. Then Jemini Ganesan tells her to share the pain by taking alcohol. He tells her to drink the alcohol also. Then at that time, Savitri Garu also drinks alcohol. From this point, her life turns into ashes. And she directs a movie. And on the release day of her movie, she comes to know that her husband is having another affair with another woman. So in this depression, she avoids her husband also because she thinks that he didn't love her truly. So she finally leaves him and she also starts consuming alcohol in lots of amounts. And that led her to go into coma and her property will be lost because her assistant cheats her. Since she is in depression, she can't able to manage her own property. So she loses everything and she makes her daughter get married. She completes the marriage. Then she takes her son and goes to Bangalore and stays in a hotel. There she remembers Jemini Ganesan a lot and there she consumes alcohol to forget him and to forget the memories. Then she goes to coma and finally she dies. She takes her last breath on December 26, 1981, which made all of the fans into tears, which had put all of the fans in tears. And from this movie, I learned that we should not trust anyone blindly. And also with hard work and determination, we can achieve anything in our life. Thank you, ma'am.
Well done, ma'am. exact 3 minutes, 4 minutes to be precise. You started at around 1:44, 45, 46, 47, 45, 5 minutes, it's done. Well spaced, Sharanya. And you did it extempore without looking at anything. But then, what's your take on the film? You just gave the initial credits of the review, which banner, who are the actors, actresses, and you went into the life story of Savitri. How is her life depicted? What is your take on the film? And which genre does it come under? Is it a biopic?
Yeah, or it's a biopic of Savitri.
Yeah.
Yes, it's a biopic. Sorry.
So what is your take on it? So what's your take?
Yeah.
How did you like the film? What are the parts that you didn't like the film?
Yes, ma'am. First half will give us goosebumps actually, because with her legendary acting, we will get goosebumps by seeing the movies like Miss Amma and Mogamanasulu, which are very beautiful movies. And the second part of the movie will put us in tears, because she, being a legendary actress, she takes alcohol and she's not able to survive actually, tolerate the depression, and which will put us in tears. It is actually a motivational movie.
Okay, what motivated you in this?
Because she doesn't know acting in the starting. When she is removed from the part, she, in aggressiveness, she learns everything. She practices a lot and she learns. And also, we should not trust anyone blindly, as she loves Jemini Ganeshan very blindly. We should not trust anyone blindly. I came to know that we are the one who should believe us only, not everyone, not others also. That I learned.
Okay. Well done. Any questions from others?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
I want to ask that there in life many situations comes that where we have to sacrifice our principles. Every person has a principle in his life, his or her life. But in life, at some stage, at some point, that person has to forget his principle and go with the flow. At that case, you can't keep that motive that don't trust anybody blindly. What to do in that case?
Okay.
Do you have an answer, Sharanya?
Yes, ma'am. We should believe in ourselves first. That is the main point of view, actually. When trusting blindly means we should not trust anyone actually, not to a full length. We have limits in everything, right? So we should trust only ourselves. Means we should have only trust on us, not on anyone. We should also love them, but not limit to a single love. That we will give life to them, we will sacrifice everything, we will lose everything. We should love, but not more than the limit.
Yes.
Suchitra ma'am, Anita ma'am's computer was shut down. So, do you have any feedback for Shivani? Sharanya? Oh,
ma'am, yours is muted.
Suchitra ma'am, you are on mute.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah.
To Anita's question, I would like to add something what she said. Is what she wants to say is that not to believe someone blindly is not that. What she means say is that when things fail, when you believe someone and when things fail, you don't have to give up your life for that. Because life is only for once, and we need to give a meaningful life. She could have stopped her drinking, yet she would have continued her profession and helped so many to come out of that. See, all cannot be successful. We learn through our failures what it is. And I think what she meant to say was that her movie is a lesson to every girl or a boy who blindly believes in love And yeah, sometimes, as Arvind said, that is the age that we definitely fall in love. We don't think of reasoning. Even if it fails, we don't have to give up our life for that. We don't have to give up our life for that. We believe in ourselves and take our life forward, at least help the others. If we don't get what, everybody will not be successful in love. But that doesn't mean we need to give up our life. We need to live for others. And for Sharanya, yes, Sharanya, that was a really very beautiful way of expressing and the time management that you have done. And I can see a lot of potential in you, Sharanya. All the thing is that you need exposure like this. Yes, where you need to keep on talking, right? Keep on present your views and all. And this is your first class, maybe like how we have seen the other students, you know, they come second time to speak, a lot of improvement. Yeah. So congratulations on that. And please keep doing this good work. Keep improving. We would like to see you in flying colors.
And Shivani also, first time you are presenting. Shivani, are you there? Shivani?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So, first presentation you chose to, but you rushed through it. It was very fast. You have seen how slow we are speaking, as if we are conversing with each other, right? That kind of conversational tone you should bring in your presentation. Go slow, no hurry.
Okay? That will improve.
Then your language is good, pronunciation is good, all of you, all five, six of you. Language is good, pronunciation is good. You are independent thinking, you have good ideas, and you can speak extempore. Then and there you can speak. So go slow. Take time for your thoughts to come into your words. Okay? And coming to Arindam. Arindam, the question that you asked, Sharanya, I must tell you, with the kind of life that Mahanati Savitri had, at very young age, she went to the zenith. But then pitfalls always happen. And always in our life, the person whom you trust the most is the one who betrays you. It is there.
Yes, ma'am.
So where you invest your complete trust and belief, and you blindly believe, you are meant to get hurt. But that doesn't mean that you stop trusting people. That doesn't mean that you stop loving people. Yes,
ma'am. That's what I mean to say that.
You compromise on some principles and all that for one person.
Yes, ma'am.
And you end up getting betrayed.
Yes, ma'am. No, the thing is, you should give that much trust only how much you can be able to handle when the loved person leaves you.
Okay. But love doesn't come in proportions, or itna karoge to itna, it cannot be measured. So yes, there'll be an aspect in all our lives where we cross that threshold, the limits that you impose on yourself. Itna hi chahiye, that after beyond a point I'll get hurt, or set your priorities right. That might not work out always. Everybody moves out of that line, that threshold. They get hurt, they fall back. But then after falling back, it is up to you to build up, to stand up.
Yes, ma'am.
That is where most of the people have failed.
Not to pick up yourself. It is important that how we overcome the situation when someone
betrays you.
Yeah,
you know, she has utterly deprived her duties as a mother. You know, she did not concentrate on her children. It's a very negative impact, right? She could have done many things in her life. As Bangla man says, failures happen, but then that is not the end of our life. We need to pull up.
Yes, ma'am. Like that.
It is a very nice session. You all enjoyed it.
Yes, ma'am. She was having her... Okay. Her son with him, with her. So she should have, instead of getting depressed because of her husband, she would have focused on her son and moved on so that her son would have achieved something good and some positive mindset he would have achieved.
Yes. And moreover, Mahanati Savitri was a multifaceted personality. She was the first person who could drive a car, horse ride. Not only that, she was an ardent fan of cricket and hockey. And she also invested in races. And she was the only person, the first Indian woman who had an all-woman team in her film production. They made a film, including the cast, assistant director, makeup person, spot girls, spot boys, all were women. That was the first kind of a revolutionary thing that she did. There are many faces to Mahanati Savitri,
yes,
which I think the film couldn't portray. Of course, you can't portray everybody, one's life, into a 3 hour or 1.5 hour film. It's a very well
yes,
done.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So and I think, says you that because she's blessed with so many things in her life, she never made use of them properly.
Yeah.
She was really a blessed person. By God has showered so much of blessings on her, but she tried to sustain all her blessings and stick on to one particular phase of her life, that is her love towards her husband. So that was her failure. So we have to learn from their failures what we should not repeat in our lives.
But everybody has this tragic flaw, that one weakness in their life,
yes,
which causes the downfall. That only after the lifetime is over, people will realize.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So that's it.
At the end of the life, any person realizes that I shouldn't have done this thing, then I would have achieved more things in life.
So
that regret everybody
that
will have.
This movie was, yes, let it not be in the end, let be in the beginning that realize.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll end this meeting, ma'am.
Yes. So come prepared with good pics tomorrow. It was really interesting. Thank you very much. We really had a nice time with you all.
So tomorrow,
stay safe,
one more second.
Yes,
okay? Right, ma'am. Ending this meeting. Thank you.
Monday we'll come back.
Monday
we'll meet. Monday.